So Carlo Farini, how did you choose him as a consultant?
We choose together because in 1990 I was a worker in aviation, and he was the consultant of the Chianti Classico Consortium, and he went to aviation the first time for a visit, and I was there as a worker, and my first work was to take the wine from an old bottle to let taste to Carlo Farini. It was an old wooden bottle with a robinet like this and with a little stopper and something that you put on the stopper. And it was my second time in the cellar in my life. And I took the decanter under the robinet, I turned the tank thing that you can with that and the stopper. And the wine was going in the decanter. I didn't know what to do, you know. And the owner was the wine. They terrorized me. And I was there with this decanter, and the wine going up, and I don't know what to do. And Carlo came immediately and said, "Stop that! You make him crazy." And he come to me and say, "Look at that. Put your finger. Put it here. Put down. Take the stopper. Take the decanter again. Put it here. It's done. It's finished. No panic. No problem." I see a man that helped me, you know, and that I love him for that. And we start to talk about wine, about our passion, and we both realized that we were completely crazy about Bordeaux, and he teach me champagne also, because I was not a wine drinker of champagne, and he is a great fascinator of champagne. And now champagne in Bordeaux are the wine that I drink more than normal. And Carlo, I asked him, I'm looking for a wine, there's more wine. I need something with a great potential, not the big house, not the big things, and something good. Can you help me to find the right wine? And he told me, okay, if you want, whatever you see for sale, you call me and I come to see you, yes or no. When we saw La Massa, was after about 50 wineries that they say no to everyone. That's not good. No possibilities. Okay. And when we found La Massa, he told me that that would be spectacular. Wine here, it would be very easy, but you will never get the money to buy it. Say, I don't worry, I will try. And this was owned by a bank, and the bank sold the property with a big finance. I took all the property, I split the property in three parts, sell two parts, and keep the central part. But I'm still paying, I'm still involved in that. And he was my consultant, because in 1992 he left the consortium and he started to be a free consultant. And we start together, he teach me everything. At the beginning, I was a cellar man of Carlo Farini, honestly, because he teach me whatever, how to pump wine, how to clean a bottle, whatever. He was very free, he was, had less wine than now. But the evolution that we had together was very, very important. For me, he was the most important person in the beginning of my life. Actually, he gave me the opportunity to develop my personality, and now more and more when we see, we just talk. We talk about everything. And the only important moment when we meet is when we do the planning, when we do the tasting, because you have a spectacular amount. Mm-hmm. You have an amount of somebody who tastes under 50 wine a day. And if you tell him, I want a little bit more in the back, in two or three attempts, 10% of that, then that, and the wine will be here. He is a spectacular taster. And was for me the biggest help of my career, absolutely.
So speaking of Bordeaux, what are your favorite chateaus?
Depends on the vintage. I think the Bordeaux have a very apart from the famous old vintages of Bordeaux, the 47, 59, 61, 70. They are spectacular vintage. I think that the decade between 80 and 90, they make the best Bordeaux ever.
82, 86.
82, 85, 83, 86, Margaux.
I know.
86, 88, 89, 90. They were a series of wine that I think they teach to the rest of the world how to do a great wine. After that, Bordeaux had the problem, I think, because I think the influence of Parker was too big. Mm-hmm. And the wine after 1990 in Bordeaux, they became more technical, more cold.